In this video, we'll be looking at the four most common types of backflow preventers. Backflow is the undesirable reverse flow of water or mixtures of water and other undesirable substances back into the potable water supply. Backflow preventers are designed to protect the municipal water supply. Let's begin by looking at the four most common types of backflow prevention devices. The type of device that you'll choose will likely be a function of the amount of protection that you need for your irrigation system and the local codes. The first backflow prevention device that we'll be looking at is the anti-siphon valve, or ASV. Anti-siphon valves have a lot of flexibility. They're the least expensive of the backflow prevention options, but they also provide the least amount of protection. Anti-siphon valves can be plastic or brass, manual or electric. They have to be installed 6 inches above the highest emission point, and they are not intended to have continuous pressure on the downstream side. In other words, it cannot be used as a master valve. The next level up in terms of price and protection provided is called a pressure vacuum breaker, or PVB. PVBs are typically installed at the residential level. A PVB must be installed 12 inches above the highest emission point. The advantage of this device is that you can install multiple zone valves in valve boxes underground after the device. It's important to note that both the anti-siphon valve and the pressure vacuum breaker only protect against back siphonage. The next two devices that we'll be talking about, the double check and the reduced pressure assembly, both provide protection against not only back siphonage, but back pressure. A double check valve, also called a DCV, is appropriate for residential and commercial installations where there is continuous pressure. One of the nice benefits of a DCV is that it can be installed in a valve box underground. Be sure to check your codes at the local level, as a DCV doesn't always meet the requirements for an irrigation system. This is because they are not designed for health hazard situations, such as an irrigation system with a fertilizer injector. The last device that we'll talk about provides the highest degree of protection. It is called a reduced pressure assembly or reduced pressure zone. These types of devices are required for health hazard situations and must be used when using a fertilizer injector. Unlike the DCV, which can be installed in a valve box underground, the RP must be installed 12 inches above grade. Like the double check, you may have emission devices that are at a higher elevation than the height of the RPA. The last thing to note, and this is important, is that the RP reduces pressure by about 10 to 14 PSI as the water passes through the device. Make sure to take this into consideration with your design. The final thing to note is that with the exception of the anti-siphon valve, all of the remaining backflow devices we talked about need to be inspected and certified on an annual basis. In some areas, they must also be installed by a certified backflow technician. So be sure to check your local codes. All of the backflow products that we've talked about today can be found at your local Ewing branch. To find a location near you, or to shop online, visit us at ewingirrigation.com.